Let's go through the time and sales column in Bookmap. In this current session range volume profile, I'll right click and come down and select the data type time and sales, and pops up the new time and sales column here. It is displaying the time, the specific price, and the volume that traded. Let's widen this out just a little bit here by left clicking and dragging, and you can also widen or narrow the specific column sizes here. Now you can show all the transactions that are going through, or specifically just the buy transactions or the sell transactions, or all. You can also filter for the size going through if you want to see a minimum size, a maximum size, or both. And then this box here, if selected, is going to show individual trades that have taken place. So for example, when it is unselected, let's say a block trade, a market buy order for the S&P E-mini for 100 lots goes through, and you see that in the size here. Now, if this box is checked, instead of seeing that 100 lot order go through, you're going to see all the different individual transactions that took place that composed that 100 lot block order. Let's collapse all our different settings and go over the next button here. You can export all of your time and sales information here in a CSV file. Click on that and you can give it a name here, and it's going to export all the data since when you opened up this time and sales column. The next option over here detaches the time and sales column from the bookmap columns here, and it opens it up in a separate window. Here you can resize and arrange this window wherever you like within your chart layout. You can see that this column is specific for the S&P E-mini. So let's go to another instrument here and open up another time and sales column and detach that as well. So now you can see we can have multiple time and sales windows open up for the different instruments, and you can arrange them as you like. If you want to pop them back into the columns, just click on the X button here and they'll pop back in. Let's do the same for the S&P, come back, and you can see here it's back in the columns. Left click, hold, and drag to arrange that wherever we like.